Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a linked services in DataFactory using as a source an IBM Informix on-premise database. First, I would like you to understand the architecture that we have. As you know, when we have to connect a service in the cloud as DataFactory with an on-premise service like Informix database, one of the suggested options is to configure a self-hosted integration runtime. So we have the on-premises Informix machine, and we are going to create another VM where we are going to configure the self-hosted integration runtime. Of course, it's possible to configure the self-hosted integration runtime in the same machine of the Informix database, but the resources in the machine will be shared, and that's not something recommended at all. In this link, you can see some information about the required configuration of this virtual machine. In this VM, we will need to install the Microsoft integration runtime. It's of course a must to be able to access to the Informix database from this VM, so there should be a kind of connectivity between them. This integration runtime will allow us to have a connection between the VM and the DataFactory in the cloud. We need to install the ODBC driver for Informix in the machine. And if our destination is an Azure SQL database, we need to allow the IP of this machine to reach it adding it to the firewall rules. You need to take into account that this machine is going to be the one connecting to the SQL database to ingest the data, not the DataFactory. DataFactory here is just an orchestrator. And as a final step, in the DataFactory we will create a self-hosted integration runtime and we will create a linked service using it. Okay, let's start now in our DataFactory resource. We are going to the Manage area, to the integration runtimes, and we are going to add a new one. We are going to choose the Azure self-hosted option, continue, and again self-hosted, and continue. We are going to call it VM Informix, and click on create. Okay, it's created. Now we have a couple of steps to follow to install in the virtual machine the integration runtime. From this link we can download it in the machine, and we have here the authentication key that we will need to configure it properly. We are going to close this, and the newly created integration runtime is here, but it's unavailable yet. We are going to move to the virtual machine to install it. We have it here already, so we are going to start it. We need to accept the terms. OK. Go. Install. It's warning us that this machine is configured to sleep or to hibernate. This is something that in a virtual machine shouldn't be like this, because it should be always on. So, OK. And it's done. Now we need to configure it, and for that we need to paste here the access key from the DataFactory, that is this one. If it's okay, we will have automatically a green check symbol here. Something important that I didn't mention is that this VM should have access to internet to get to Azure. If not, we need to have a proxy configuration here. We are going to register it. We can give a name to the node if we want. And it's finished. Okay, this part is ready. Let's go now to the DataFactory. And as we can see, the status changed to running, so we are good here. Now we are ready to use it in any linked service that we create. So let's create one. Informix type. We are going to call it our Informix database. In the integration runtime, we need to choose the self-hosted that we created, and as a connection string, we need to add something with this format. We need to specify the ODBC driver that we need to use, and we need to enter the parameters values that you see, the server, the host, the port, the protocol, and the database name. Then we need to add the user and the password, and we can now test the connection. It's successful, so we are ready to start working on DataFactory using this linked service. And that's it. I hope you found this video useful, and thanks a lot for watching.